My name's Major Sam McGrath and I run the Parachute Regiment Selection Course, P Company. I promoted to the rank of Major and commanded nearly 200 guys just after my 28th birthday. At the time I was the youngest Major in the British Army. One of the most demanding things I've ever done was fighting amongst my comrades in Afghanistan. On a daily basis, we were up against a very fierce enemy. Each time we went out the door, we didn't know what we were going to face. The para mindset, the para training prepared me for that. And over the course of a couple of weeks, I became conditioned to that environment. The parachute run was extremely difficult. We have at least 12 hours in a plane. We then would drop probably 10 miles away from the objective, and we then must march from our drop zone to the objective over 10 miles carrying Bergen's rucksacks in excess of 120 pounds. So that requires a physical resilience and a mental fortitude to cope with that kind of stress and that anxiety. By the time our guys get to the battle, they've already gone through a degrading process, and so we need guys that aren't only fit enough for that, but they're mentally resilient enough for that kind of challenge. The para selection course is made up of 8 tests, and they test all aspects of physical fitness: strength, speed, endurance and flexibility. It starts off with a 10-mile march carrying 35 pounds over mountainous terrain. Go! We then do an aerial confidence course where we train soldiers to overcome fear at heights of 55 feet.
And it prepares people for the uncertainty of jumping out of the plane for the first time.
Stand by!
We get people to do very simple things, but under conditions of stress.
Okay, stop there! Touch your toes!
P Company constantly takes people outside of their comfort zone. Go!
We then move on to a log race, where soldiers run at best speed, 2 miles carrying half a telegraph pole. And physically, that is the hardest 15 minutes of any bloke in the para's life.
No!
It is emotional.
Those big questions, straight into it.
We then do a 2 mile steeplechase course, cross country water obstacle route.
Good!
Wipe out!
2 miler sees soldiers running best effort, carrying all their battle equipment, aiming to get in within 18 minutes.
Come on, speed and aggression, all the way in!
We train for war, not exercise, and that translates brilliantly to life outside the army. You know, stress isn't something that's restricted to the battlefield, it's something that everybody has to deal with. If you're fit, both in your mind and your body, you're able to cope with that stress much better. And that's exactly what the para training course is all about.
Heart and lungs and your legs need to be burning. Maximum effort, you want to pass this course. Does everybody understand me?
Yes, sir!
One of the things I've done in this book is I've broken down the obstacles to getting fit into 2 components. Firstly, the physical challenge, and secondly, the mental challenge. Now, I believe the most significant challenge is the mental challenge. Fitness is as much about emotional commitment as it is about physical resilience. The most difficult thing you'll do on a run is putting on your trainers and getting out the door. Okay, and that is my big challenge, and that is what I'll impart in this book. It is how you get those trainers on and you set off. Because once you set off, you have broken the back of it. You are 50% there, and momentum will keep you going. It's identifying a clear goal, which is specific and time-related, and working out exactly what it is that you want to achieve in your training program. That is the process that I explain, and I war game through this book, where I take you from where you are now, where you want to be, and I give you the mental and the physical ingredients to get from your start point to your destination. Now, you can do that in 2 ways. You can do that with spit and sawdust on our para Spartan program, where you require nothing more than a pair of trainers, okay, which is built on running and circuit training exercises. Or you can do that in our EMPA program, which is basically where you take some luxury and you integrate that into the program to make it more enjoyable. Whether that's going to a gym, whether that's integrating sport into your program, whether that's going to aerobics classes, whether that's hill walking. It's finding things which achieve the same objective that you need from that training session.
Come on, let's go to catch them up, feed it up. Good.
In 5 weeks, this program can change your life. Whether you're fighting a fierce enemy or a sedentary lifestyle, second place is defeat and an early grave. And that is our challenge. It is how we overcome that obstacle and we get you fit, fit for life, and fit for the challenges that face you.